Hello, Sasha here, and welcome to the kitchen. So today we're gonna do some chocolates, Herbie chocolates, and it's very, very easy. I'm gonna show you what you need. So you will need a bowl, any kind of bowl, some mold, so you can just do tiny chocolates. I've got one shaped as Herbalife. You can buy that in a $2 shop very easily. They have like stars, moons, and dinosaurs. Really, really cool. And then if you want to do some flat one, I'm going to show you how to do that with just a platter, so a baking paper on top. And then you want to have a teaspoon and a normal spoon, and you want to have like a spatula, so you just can stir the whole mixture. Then you want to have one or two Formula One. You can just choose, but always have like a chocolate flavor. This is going to be the best. If you don't have chocolate and you only have vanilla, I suggest you just add a teaspoon or a tablespoon of cocoa, and that really will give you that chocolate flavor. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to use just the Herbalife products because it's got more nutrition for you. And then I've got the personalized protein powder, so we can add protein in those chocolates so it fills up and you feel full. And then I've got a cup of oats, and then I have some almonds. So you can choose any kind of nuts, but I've just got some almonds, so we're gonna do the flat ones. And the most important ingredient is coconut oil. So this one is from Nature's Way. You can use any type of organic coconut oil, and this is the best. Okay, so let's get started. So the first thing that I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use the chocolate. So let's use the chocolate. So I'm gonna have one scoop and a second scoop in there. Now I'm gonna do a big batch, so I'm gonna put two more scoops of cookies and cream. Now why I like cookies and cream is because it's got chocolate bits and it's got like a creamy flavor, so I love adding cookies and cream to this recipe. Okay, so second thing that I'm gonna do is add some personalized protein powder. So one scoop and two scoops. All right, this is it. Okay, so what's the next thing is we're gonna do coconut oil. So it's gonna be very, very easy. What you're gonna do, you're just gonna take a spoon. So as you can see, the coconut oil is already dissolved. You know, it's just very liquid. So what you wanna do is, if it's really, really hard, just put it for, you know, a few seconds in the microwave and it will be liquefied. But I'm just gonna add it like this. It's the perfect texture. So 2 tablespoons so far, and I'm gonna stir this because you want to make sure it's nice and stirred along the way, because you don't want to do just add the coconut oil and then stir, because it just, yeah, it just doesn't create a nice texture from the start. You got to work it. So as you can see, you got some grain. All right, one more spoon. So this is our third and fourth teaspoon, and let's stir it. There we go, it's getting a bit more chocolatey now. Just work it. So this is 4 tablespoons of coconut oil so far, and it's like a hard cake mix. It's so fun. You could still use it like this, but I like it nice and liquidy, especially if we're gonna add some hard ingredients like oats. So I'm gonna use one more. So this is our fifth And I think that should do the trick there because it's quite chocolatey now. There we go. You want that kind of texture, like very sticky but lumpy. Okay. Very nice chocolate. This is just chocolate. Okay. Now this is the fun part. This is where you can add any type of ingredients to your mix. And I'm going to add a little bit of oats. So as you can see, I've just added enough to sprinkle it. Just make sure you add a little bit first, mix it, and then if the texture is what you like it like, then you just stop there. But you can add more if you want, like a hard chocolate full of oats. This is what I like. I like this kind of chocolate. I like when it's a bit lumpy. Okay, this is the fun part. So I'm going to show you. So take your flat platter and add, I'm going to add it like this. So add one big spoon and drop it on the platter. I don't know if you can see that. Oops, I'm making a mess. Okay, second big splatter. There we go. Now I'm just going to make sure it's nice and flat on the baking paper. And I'm going to do like a round shape. You can do any type of shape. You just be creative with your chocolate. I just like it. Like that. Okay. And now I'm going to take my little almonds. And as you can see, they're cut in half. So you can actually see they're just very nice and thin. And I'm going to put them on top of the chocolate, just like so. Just be creative. Like you could have cashews, you could have macadamias, but almonds is what I had. Those ones are nice and oven dried. They're healthier for you. There we go, almost done. There we go, I've just got enough. I finished all the almonds. Got enough for that little bit there. So as you can see, it's nice and pretty. Now, I'm gonna put this in the freezer straight away. This is the best, very beautiful. This is the best, you just leave it for 20 minutes in the freezer and it will set. And then because the baking paper is just a protection underneath, it just flops. You just put a knife underneath and it just comes up and you can actually cut it in little pieces and eat it like that. And they're so yummy. All right, in the freezer. All right, I'm back for those little ones. So we're gonna do those little ones and I can't use that big spoon to put the chocolate mixture in it. So I'm gonna use a teaspoon. So what you do, I'm just gonna come up there, take a teaspoon, and you make sure it drops right in there. Doesn't matter if you make a mess around the corners. It really goes in there anyway. It's just chocolate. These ones are so easy because you just put them in there and then once it's in the freezer, it's just nice and hard. They come out nicely in the shape that you like. They're so great for the kids as well. A bit too much in that one. You can correct the holes and just add a bit more in another one and a bit less. Okay, now I'm just going to clean the chocolate off that spoon because I don't like waste, and this is a bit of waste. I'm going to lick this later. Okay, as you can see, I don't have much chocolate left, so it's enough for a little bit of in the mold. Oh, I'm making a mess. Anybody could do it. I mean, look at that. I'm doing a mess, but I'm still managing to get the chocolate in. There you go. Almost done. Cleaning up the edges is the best part, because then you can eat the chocolate along the way. Go. Okay. Just had enough for a little one at the end. That's okay. Doesn't matter. Main thing is the chocolate is perfectly in mold. So if you had bigger molds, I would do more scoops of Formula One and more scoops of the protein powder with you just double up, you know, like this is, we used, what is this used? I think we used 4 tablespoons of the coconut oil, and we used 4 scoops of the Formula One and 2 scoops of the protein powder. So just double up and you will have more chocolate. So for bigger molds. So this is very messy, but doesn't really matter. Like the chocolate will come off anyway, the little bits that's around. Doesn't matter if you are a freak and wants to clean, you can just lick it around and it'll be all good. But this is it. Now I'm gonna put this in the freezer for 20 minutes and it will be nice and set. Sometimes because it's so small, it finishes quicker, so like 10 minutes and it'll be all set. All right. That's it. That was it. And I hope you enjoyed the recipe. If you want to see the results of those chocolate, make sure you follow us at Hooked on Nutrition on Facebook and you will see the beautiful results of the chocolates. And I'll see you on the next video.